since thermodynamics is a part of physics, thermodynamics has to live peacefully with other branches of physics. It turns out that many quantities defined in other branches of physics, many concepts, laws which are available in other branches of physics are used by thermodynamics without questioning them. For example, the laws of mechanics, the laws of fluid mechanics, the laws of electricity and magnetism, the laws of gravitation. These are all accepted by thermodynamics as true because they have been developed by other associated branches of physics. Such things which are defined in other branches of physics and used by thermodynamics are known as primitives in thermodynamics. There are many sciences from which thermodynamics derives its primitives. For example, geometry. From geometry, we will be using the concepts of length, area, volume, and all the properties of length, areas, volumes, and other geometric identities which we have derived, they are accepted in thermodynamics as true. They are primitives in thermodynamics. We will not be defining them again. From mechanics, we will be using ideas of velocity, kinetic energy, potential energy, and any other thing which is needed. From electricity, we will be using charge, current, voltage, electric power, etc. There are two ideas which lie on the borderlines of primitives and concepts of thermodynamics. These two ideas are work and energy. Both are defined in other branches of physics. Work is defined in mechanics, fluid mechanics, electricity and magnetism. Energy is defined in almost all branches of physics. We have various components of energy. So these two will form the links between other branches of physics and thermodynamics, and we will be redefining them in thermodynamics. While doing this, we will see to it that we are not disturbing their characteristics as discussed in other branches of physics. Thank you.